فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Are you with me? And he says, على القول الجديد according to the new opinion. Are you with me, brothers? And when he says قول الجديد, what does he mean? He means اجتهاد الشافعي الجديد. الإمام الشافعي, his new opinion that he held. الإمام الشافعي had two views. One is known as the view that he held in Iraq, when he was in Iraq. Are you with me, brothers? If you ever hear Abu Thawr transmit something from Imam Shafi'i, that's the Qawl al-Qadim. If Ahmad ibn Hanbal transmits a Qawl from Shafi'i, that's Qawl al-Qadim. Lakin if Al-Imam Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, Al-Buwayti, if they transmit it, this is Qawl al-Jadid. Are you with me? Because he was in Egypt this time. Shafi'i changed his opinion. And this shows you that these ulama used to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When their knowledge increased, they would change the ruling. And they were people of dalil. And they didn't care what people said. Oh, you didn't know, now you know, look at you changing your opinion. The deenullah, this is the religion of Allah. Even though he was grounded in the beginning, Shafi'i, he changed his opinion. And it was taken from him. But this qawl that Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni is saying, that this is the new view of Shafi'i, fihi nazar. So look to it. Because Al-Imam Al-Ala'i Al-Kaykaldi has a book called Ijmal al-Isaba. And also Ibn al-Qayyim in his kitab I'lam al-Muqqi'in, they both say, this is not the qawl al-jadid of Imam Shafi'i at all. So they do ta'qib on him. And they are right over what he's saying here. Anyways, when he says, brothers, pay attention to this. When he says, وَقَوْلُ الْوَاحِدِ, don't think to yourself he only means one particular companion. It can be two companions if he wants. If they are holding that opinion, he's looking at the opinion which is one, not the number. For example, Ibn Umar and Ibn Abbas, both of them, they used to believe that غسل الميت, if you wash the dead, ينقض الوضوء, it breaks the wudu. That's what they believe. But this for him, it will be considered as what? قول الواحد, one person's view. Because both of them are saying the same thing. That's what he means by it. Now brothers, pay it, understand this issue. This statement of the author has to become understood properly, which is, him leaving it unrestricted like that is not tahqiq. It's not done with what? Tahqiq. And the strongest is that qawl of the sahabi is a hujjah bi shartain, with two conditions present. Number one, adami mukhalafati ahada min as-sahaba, if he doesn't oppose any other companion. As long as there's no other companions opposing him, which is the first condition. And the second condition, is that he is not opposing عدم مخالفتي دليلا, he's not opposing a evidence which is أرجح من القرآن أو السنة. He's not opposing a دليل أرجح more apparent من القرآن, from the Quran or the Sunnah. نعم.
وما الأخبار؟ الخبر ما يدخله الصدق والكذب، والخبر ينقسم إلى قسمين، آحاد ومتواتر. فالمتواتر ما يوجب العلم، وهو أن يروي جماعة لا يقع التواتر على الكذب من مثلهم، إلى أن ينتهي إلى المخبر عنه، ويكون في الأصل عن مشاهدة أو سماع، لا عن اجتهاد. والآحاد هو الذي يوجب العمل ولا يوجب العلم. ينقسم الى المرسل والمسند، فالمسند ما اتصل اسناده، والمرسل ما لم يتصل اسناده، فان كان من مراسيل غير الصحابه فليس بحجه، الا مراسيل سعيد بن مسيب فانها فتشت ووجدت مسانيد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، والعنعنة تدخل على الأسانيد. وإذا قرأ الشيخ يجوز للراوي أن يقول حدثني أو أخبرني، وإن قرأ هو على الشيخ فيقول أخبرني ولا يقول حدثني، فإن أجازه الشيخ من غير رواية فيقول أجازني أو أخبرني إجازة.
The author رحمه الله, he goes into another unit in which is dealt with in usul al-fiqh called al-akhbar. And akhbar is the plural of what? Khabar. The author defined it as to be what? فَالْخَبَرُ مَا يَدْخُلُهُ الصِّدْقُ وَالْكَذِبُ. And we previously mentioned that that qawl is not correct. We made clear that the qawl in which حَرَّرَهُ ibn الشَّعَاط رحمه الله in his مختصر, in the مختصر الفروق by Imam al-Qarafi, he summarized it. He mentions that it has to be what? قول يلزمه الصدق أو الكذب. It is a speech which it will يلزمه, in a, it is obligatory to either become truthful or it becomes a lie. One of the two has to take. So that's what the definition that we have chosen. Then he has mentioned the author الخبر ينقسم إلى قسمين, that the خبر is divided into two, أحد singular or even few, or mutawatirin, which is multitude. This is the categorization of khabar in terms of what? بِاعْتِبَارِ وُصُولِهِ بِاعْتِبَارِ وُصُولِهِ إِلَيْنَا, how it reaches us, right? This is the types that we categorize it into. The author talking about this in usul al-fiqh is really not incorrect. This is none of his business. This is done by, is studied and is spoken about in another field. These are another people's job. His job, usul al-fiqh, is nothing to do with authentication and weakening and how something reached us. He should, usul al-fiqh, should only deal with what? How to extract a ruling from a dalil. Are you with me, brothers? So what we can say is this is ajnabi. It's a foreigner in this field. And when you look at these definitions that the usuliyin give to khabar, ama mutawatir, أما أحد, don't take it from them. Don't take it from them. So it's none of your business. It's the ulama al-hadith's job. They're the ones that this field deals with. So this is what happens to so many people. When they are talking about the concept of mursal, they look at the works of the usuliyin and they take on board the qawl of the usuliyin and they turn a blind eye to the qawl of the muhaddithin. And this is the job of who? The muhaddithin, they're the ones who define what mursal is and whether mursal is a hujjah or not, or whether it's accepted or not, and what the definition of a mursal is, and how should a mursal be defined. You're going to see him define mursal to be what? أَيُّ نُعْ مِنْ أَنْوَاعِ الْإِنْقِطَاعِ. He's going to define mursal to be any form of this disconnection. Is that correct? Mursal is what? مَا أَسْنَدَهُ التَّابِعِيُّ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. It's whatever a tabi'i attributes to who? The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. But for him, the mu'allaq, the munqati', the mu'dal, and the mursal, all of them for him is mursal. صح? So when you're studying a science, brothers, learn which one is which's job. And take each one from the people of that field. And say, this is your job, I'll take it from you. But when it comes to extracting ahkam from a what? From the nusus al-wahiyyin, the kitab and the sunnah, you leave that for the usuliyin, that's their job. And they will tell you how to do that. Are you with me, brothers? You don't take that from the fuqaha. Take it from the usuliyin. Okay? So now what he does is that he categorizes it into two, al-mutawatir and ahad. And then he says when he defines it, he doesn't define it, he rather gives you the ruling of the mutawatir. He goes, is ma yujibu al-ilma, it's anything that what? Necessitates and obligates and makes mandatory ilm. Ilm here, he means al-yaqiniyu al-daruriyu. Necessity, like knowledge which is known out of necessity. And then he tries to define what it means. He defines it and he says, وَهُوَ أَنْ يَرْوِي جَمَاعَةٌ لَا يَقَعُ التَّوَاطُوُ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ مِنْ مِثْلِهِمْ إِلَىٰ أَيَّتَي إِلَىٰ الْمُخْبَرِ عَنْهُ وَيَكُونُ فِي الْأَصْلِ عَنْ مُشَاهَدَةٍ أَوْ سَمَاعٍ لَا عَنْ اجْتِهَادٍ. So he mentions four things that the mutawatir needs to have. First of all is يَرْوِيهِ جَمَاعَةٌ, a large amount of people need to narrate it. Number two, أَلَّا يَتَوَطَّ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ مِنْ مِثْلِهِمْ, it's that it is impossible that they can come in any way, form or shape, agree with each other on this. Third, أَنَّ ذَلِكَ يَسْتَمِرُّ, and that this also carries on فِي جَمِيعِ طَبَقَاتِ السَّنَدِ, it takes place in every part of the chain. So the tawatur doesn't happen in just one tabaqa. It happens in all of the tabaqa of the sanad. And the fourth one, which is أن يكون في الأصل عن مشاهدة أو سماع لا عن اجتهاد. And that it goes back to حدثنا أخبرنا. He can't say, oh, I think so, I assume. No. It has to all be based upon أخبرنا أنبأنا. Are you with me? It has to be مشاهدة. I heard. And he left the fifth one, which the ulama of Mustalah mentioned. It's five that the conditions that they give. Go to the sharh of Nukbatul Fikr. Then the author, rahimahullah, he gives you the ruling of what ahad is. Wal ahadu huwa alladhi yujibu al-amala wa la yujibu al-ilma. And that's the strongest, that's the famous speech that many people use, which is ahad is what? That which obligates action, but it doesn't not obligate knowledge. But the strongest is that an al-ahad yujibu al-ilma al-nadhariyu bil-qara'in. That the ahad, even if it's a single narration, if other external factors come, it can actually become ilm. But this ilm is called ilm al-nadhari. Like the ahad that's narrated in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. It's not like the ahad that is narrated in any other place. This ahad is not dhanni. It's not just based upon, are you with me brothers? It's based upon ilm. And then the author, rahimahullah, he divides the ahad into two. He says, وَيَنْقَسِمُ إِلَىٰ مُرْسَلٍ وَمُسْنَدٍ. He divided it into two. And then he defined what musnad means, and he defined what mursal means. He said musnad is what? مَتَّصَلَ إِسْنَادُ. Anything which its chain is connected. And then the mursal, he says, مَا لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ إِسْنَادُ. That which its chain is not connected. You see, every type of disconnection for him is a mursal. That's wrong. The mursal is what? مَا أَضَافَهُ التَّابِعُيُّ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صح. Mursal is what the companion tabi'i attributes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And even musnad is what? Musnad is what? It's marfu' al-sahabi. It's whatever a sahabi attributes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bisanadin zahiru ittisal. But it's a chain of narration from the apparent, it's connected. Then he mentions the ruling of the marasil. He says, فَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ مَرَاسِيلِ غَيْرِ الصَّحَابَةِ فَلَيْسَ بِحُجَّةٍ إِلَّا مَرَاسِيلَ سَعِيدِ بْنُ الْمُسَيَّبِ فَإِنَّهُ فُتِّشَتْ فَوُجِدَتْ مَسَانِيدَ عَنِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He gives you three views, three قول regarding the مراسيل. Three. The first one is قبول, accepting it. And he's talking about the مرسل الصحابي. The second one is rejecting it. Is that if it's a مرسل other than the صحابة's. And the third one he mentions is the accepting of the مرسل of سعيد بن المسيب. Only with the companions he's accepted. And then he tried to speak about that by saying, إِلَّا مَرَاسِيلَ سَعِيدِ بْنُ الْمُسَيَّبِ فَإِنَّهَا فُتِّشَتْ فَوُجِدَتْ مَسَانِيدَ عَنِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Because سَعِيدِ بْنُ الْمُسَيَّبِ, his مَرَاسِيل has been researched and it has been looked into. Okay? So his one's a hujjah, that's what he says. So it takes the ruling of the masanid, not the مَرَاسِيل. That becomes good. So what about Hassan al-Basri? Like Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, who's lower than Hassan al-Basri, all of them are what? Their marasil is not accepted, according to him. The only one whose marasil is accepted is who? Sa'id ibn al-Musayyab. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i gave five conditions when it's accepted. Five conditions. Shafi'i mentioned. Look it up yourselves, inshallah ta'ala. Then the author, rahimahullah, he mentions an'ana. Al-an'ana tu tadkhulu ala al-asanid. An'ana means when the narrator narrates a hadith with an. And he says, an. This is called what? An-ana. And an-ana is when they use an. An-ana means when they use an. And an-ana means when they use an. That's what's when it's in the chain of narration. An-ana is accepted if it comes from a person who's not mudallis. If the person is a mudallis and he uses an-ana, it won't be accepted. Hatta yati, until he comes with what? تصريح السماع, until he tells us that he heard it. And he has to say أخبرنا أو أنبأنا أو حدثني. It won't be accepted. Then the author rahimahullah mentions three things that are connected to التحمل ونقل الرواية. Taking on narrations and also transmitting narrations. He mentions three things. The first one he mentions is what? وإذا قرأ الشيخ يجوز للراوي أن يقول حدثني أو أخبرني. If he reads on the shaykh, it is permissible for him to say حدثني أو أخبرني. إذا قرأ الشيخ, if the sheikh reads, it is permissible for the narrator to say حدثني, he told me, أو أخبرني. The second he mentions is, وإن قرأ هو, if he reads to the Shaykh, it is permissible for him to say أخبرني, and it is not permissible for him to say حدثني. The third point that he mentions is what? وإن أجازه الشيخ, if the teacher gives him إجازة, من غير رواية, without any رواية, فيقول, he would have to say أجازني أو أخبرني إجازة. What does he mean without a رواية? He means دون السماع وقراءة, without him reading for him. نعم.
ومن قياس الظهر ورد الفرع إلى الأصل بعلة تجمعهما في الحكم, وهو ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام, إلى قياس علة وقياس بالدلالة وقياس شبه. فقياس العلة ما كانت العلة فيه موجبة للحكم, وقياس الدلالة والاستدلال بأحد النظيرين على الآخر, وهو أن تكون العلة دالة على الحكم ولا تكون موجبة للحكم. وقياس الشبه هو الفرع المتردد بين أصلين يلحق بمختلهما شبها ولا يصار إليه مع إمكان ما قبله. ومن شرط الفرع أن يكون مناسبا للأصل, ومن شرط الأصل أن يكون ثابتا بدليل متفق عليه بين الخصمين. ومن شرط العلة أن تطرد في معلولاتها فلا تنقلب لفظا ولا معنى. ومن شرط الحكم أن يكون مثل العلة في النقلة والإثبات. والعلة هي الجاذبة للحكم, والحكم هو المجذوب للعلة.
The author rahimahullah, he mentions another unit from the units of usul al-fiqh, which is al-qiyas, analogy. وعرفه, the author defined it as follows: رد الفرع إلى الأصل بعلة تجمعهما في الحكم. The author's definition, it encompasses four points. Number one is أنه رد فرع. It is to bring a sub branch. It is to bring back a sub branch. فرع هي is المقيس المطلوب حكمه. It is the thing that you're going to do the analogy for. Give you an example. Alcohol is what? It's haram, right? Okay. What about weed? Does it intoxicate weed? Yeah? It does, right? Okay. Which is the asal? Which one are we really got a ruling for? Khamar. We know khamar. So that's the asal. What's the fara? Weed. Good. What's the ruling? What's the ruling of khamar? Haram. Why? So the intoxication is what? Illa. The intoxication is called illa. It's the reasoning. The hukum is what? Haram. Who is the asal? Who is the farah? Four pillars you already mentioned to me. Farah, which is the weed. Asal, which is the khamar. Illa, which is iskar, intoxication. And the fourth one is what? Hukum. Are you with me, brothers? Always remember those are the four pillars. The first one is taking back the farah, which is the thing you're doing in an analogy for. The second one is asal. The third one is عِلَّة تَجْمَعُهُمَا, a عِلَّة that they both share. And four is حُكُم, the ruling. Then the author رحمه الله, he mentions the types of qiyas. He says وَهُوَ يَنْقَسِمُ إِلَى ثَلَاثَةِ أَخْسَامٍ. The qiyas is divided into three: qiyas عِلَّةٍ, وقياس دَلَالَةٍ, وقياس شَبَهٍ. This is what the author رحمه الله divided the qiyas into three. And this categorization is called بِاعْتِبَارِ الْجَامِعِ بَيْنَ الْأَصْلِ وَالْفَرَعِ. It is the relationship between the asal and the fara. Then the author, rahimahullah, defined each one. He defined the first one, which is فقياس العلة ما كانت العلة فيه موجبة للحكم. In simple terms, what it is that the example I just gave you right now, which is the alcohol and the, which is ما جمع فيه بين الأصل والفرع بعلة ظاهرة. Both of them have been brought together with a illah that is ظاهر, it's apparent. The illah here is apparent. Are you with me, brothers? Then the author, rahimahullah, he mentions the second type, which is قياس الدلالة. قياس الدلالة. And he said, هو الاستدلال بأحد النظيرين على الآخر وهو أن تكون العلة دالة على الحكم ولا تكون موجبة للحكم. Another simple way, which is a more easier definition and the correct definition, which is more apparent, to be honest, is the asl and the fara are brought together because of a illa, but this illa, it's its effect and what is wajib for it. Then the author, rahimahullah, he defined qiyas al-shabah. Qiyas al-shabah means what? هو الفرع, it is a sub-branch. المتردد بين أصلين, that bounces from one between the other. In other words, the relationship between the asl and the fara, the illa is actually mutajadiba. Each one is pulling the illa to themselves. It's more stronger sometimes to this place, and it stands in this one independently, and sometimes not, it stands in this one independently. So which one do you give the hukum to? فَيُلْحَقُ بِأَكْثَرِهِمَا شَبْهًا. You give it to which one it looks the most like. And this type, which is قياس الشبه, is the weakest type of قياس, analogy. Basically what it is that you're trying to do قياس of something, but there's two things that it has قياس of. Are you with me, brothers? Are you with me, brothers? Two things here, it resembles both. But these two things are two independent things. And it shares some ilal with these two. So we give precedence to one over the other. This type of qiyas, the scholars, they see it as to be very weak qiyas. Like a slave. Is it the ruling of a human being or an animal? The animal's owned. That's one of the qiyases that they give. Condition. Remember, examples can always could be rejected or accepted. Then the author, rahimahullah, he mentions shurut min shurut arkan al-qiyas. He mentions the pillars from the pillars of qiyas, which is what? من شرط الفرع أن يكون مناسبا للأصل. From the conditions of the فرع is that it's befitting for the أصل. He also mentions أن من شرط الأصل أن يكون ثابتا بدليل متفق عليه بين الخصمين. That the أصل that you're using has to be established with an authentic, transmitted, agreed upon evidence between both parties. He also mentions من شرط العلة أن تطرد في معلوماتها فلا تنتقض لفظا ولا معنى. Is that it is present في جميع صورها, in all of its forms. He also mentions, رحمه الله, من شرط الحكم أن يكون مثل العلة في النفي والإثبات. That the conditions of the hukum is, it is the same of the illa in terms of if it's negation or if it's affirmation. And then he concluded the chapter with the relationship between the illa and the hukum. وَالْعِلَّةُ هِيَ الْجَالِبَةُ لِلْحُكْمِ وَالْحُكْمُ هُوَ الْمَجْلُوبُ لِلْعِلَّةِ. Which is what I spoke about. That what makes the alcohol haram is iskar. And what made the weed haram is iskar. So one is pushing the other one to this one. Naam.
وما الحظر والعباحة ومن الناس من يقول إن الأشياء على الحظ إلا ما أباحته الشريعة، فلم يوجد في الشريعة ما يدل على الإباحة يتمسك بالأصل وهو الحظ. ومن الناس من يقول بضده وهو أن الأصل في الأشياء أنها على الإباحة إلا ما حضره الشرع.
The scholar then now speaks about a chapter from the chapters of Usul al-Fiqh, which is Al-Asr fil-Ashiya. What's the origin law of every matter? Ashiya here means Al-A'yan al-Muntafa'i biha. Things that the people are going to benefit from. Dawat, it has to be things that the people benefit from. It is not speeches or actions. That's not what's being spoken about here. It's objects that the people benefit from. What's the original essence for it? Permissibility. Unless there comes an evidence that shows what? That it's not permissible. That's what he says. إِنَّ الْأَشْيَاءَ عَلَى الْحَضَرِ إِلَّا مَا أَبَاحَتْهُ الشَّرِيعَةِ. Some people say that. Are you with me, brothers? So the asal of things are what? Al-hadar or ibaha? Permissibility or impermissibility? The Sheikh mentions the different opinions that scholars have. One opinion says that what? There's different aqwal. The first qawl is, مِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ إِنَّ الْأَشْيَاءَ عَلَى الْحَضَرِ. All things are haram. إِلَّا مَا أَبَاحَتُ الشَّرِيعَةِ. Except the things that the Sharia made permissible. The second qawl is what? وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ بِضِدِّي. Some say the opposite, which is أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِي الْأَشْيَاءِ. That in the origin essence of everything is what? الْإِبَاحَ, permissibility. إِلَّا مَا حَضَرَهُ الشَّرْعُ. Except that which the Sharia made impermissible. So there are two views that are opposing one another. The third qawl is at-tawakuf. We don't know. Silence. What's the strongest opinion in this matter? So first of all, before we give a statement, we have to say the things are four types. The dawat, the things itself, are four types. Things that its benefit is pure, it's purely good. Then we say this is permissible. Al-asru fiha al-ibaha. The original essence of it is permissibility. Another thing which is, it's evil, pure evil. Fal-asru fihi al-hadar. It's haram. The third one is, something that doesn't have no manfa'a and doesn't have no maslaha. None of the two. And this is only present in the imaginary mind. It doesn't have no reality in the waqi'. صح? It doesn't exist. There's no such thing as this. But in the brain, you can make that up if you want to. Huh? The fourth one is, ما فيه مصلحة وفيه مفسدة. There's a maslaha in it. And there's also a mafsada in it. So whichever of those becomes strong, it takes its ruling. If the maslaha is higher, it becomes permissible. If the mafsada is higher, it becomes impermissible. Now,
ومعنى استصحاب الحال أي استصحاب الأصل عند عدم الدليل الشرعي.
The author now speaks about something called istishab, which I mentioned to you before. Istishab is from what, my beloved brothers and sisters? And qiyas previously, what was it from? Adilla far'iyya, right? Was it from the adilla asliya? It's from the adilla far'iyya. Istishab, what does it mean? It's basically using the original default position as evidence. Saying that default is a position, is evidence for me. Is what I mentioned, biqa' ma kana ala ma kan. So you say that this is permissible based on the original default position. I am innocent until you prove me guilty. What's your evidence? Well, I'm innocent. You have to prove me guilty. That's the istishab. What does istishab take evidence? When does it take weight? And when is it used? Istishab is only used عند عدم الدليل الشرعي, when there's no دليل شرعي. If there's a دليل, then of course you can't say I'm sticking to the default position. The دليل has now removed it from that. Are you with me? So istishab is saying, what's the original essence in water? Me and you are walking on the street, Somebody throws a bucket of water from the window. We don't know what they do. Did they urinate in it? Did they wash their children? What is it? And it went in our clothes, and then bam, the window got closed. And we looked up. This is Egypt. This is Egypt, brothers. Imaraha. Imara Tasa'a. Faisal. And you don't know who did it. And when you look at your clothes, you don't know what it is. Is it pure water or is it not? And you and your friend will walk into the masjid. What do you do in this situation? You stick to the asal, which is that the water is pure. And there's nothing now you have with you to say that it's not pure. Now you're using istishab as evidence. There's no other. You took it back to how water was. Are you with me, brothers? Now,
وما الأدلة فيقدم الجلي منها على الخفي والموجب للعلم على الموجب للظن والنطق على القياس القياس الجلي على الخفي وإن وجد في النطق ما يغير الأصل وإلا فيستصحب الحال.
The author رحمه الله, he mentions here a unit from the units of أصول الفقه, which is known as ترتيب الأدلة. How to put the evidences in order. Okay? And this falls under the ta'arud. It falls under the chapter of ta'arud. It follows that up. And the author, rahimahullah, mentions five murajjihat التي يقدم بها دليل على دليل. If you want to do, you want to level evidences, this is the order you put it in. Number one, barakallahu fiqh. Number one, فَيُقَدَّمُ الْجَلِيُّ مِنْهَا عَلَى الْخَفِيِّ. You give precedence to the one that's apparent over the thing that's hidden. Number two, وَالْمُوجِبُ لِلْعِلْمِ عَلَى الْمُوجِبِ لِلْظَنِّ. You give precedence to the thing that shows knowledge over the thing that shows speculation. Number three, وَالنُّطْقُ عَلَى الْقِيَاسِ. You give the Prophet ﷺ nutqu, every time he says it, he means قَوْلُ اللَّهِ, Allah's قول, and the messenger's speech. That takes precedence over what? Analogy. So if ta'arud happens, this is the order you follow. Number four, the qiyas which is jali takes precedence over the qiyas which is khafi. The qiyas which is jali is the qiyas which is apparent. And the illa is strong. Are you with me, brothers? Over the qiyas which is khafi, the hidden qiyas. Are you with me, brothers? The qiyas, by the way, which is... The qiyas which is jali is basically one that's based upon evidence. قال الله قال الرسول. The qiyas is based on that. Whereas the qiyas which is khafi is based upon istinbat. You're extracting the ruling from it. The illa is something you're looking for. But we already know the illa for khamar is iskar. We don't need to look for the illa. Are you with me? But somebody tries to go out and find something Allah made haram, why he made it haram. And he makes an illa for it. And he wants to then now use this illa that he brought out for something else. This is called istinbat. Good. Number five, which is the fifth one, which he mentions, فَإِنْ وُجِدَ فِي النُّطْقِ مَا يُغَيِّرُ الْأَصْلَ وَإِلَّا فَاسْتُصْحِبَ الْحَالُ. If we don't find in the speech of Allah and the speech of the Messenger anything that changes the asl, meaning the default position is not being changed, no ruling has changed it, then he says we will use that. بَرَاءَةُ الْأَصْلِيَّةِ. We use the default position. وَإِلَّا فَيُسْتَصْحَبُ الْحَالُ. This is عدم وجود الدليل, when there is no دليل found. That's ترتيب الأدلة that he mentions. هيا.
ومن شرط المفتي أن يكون عالما بالفقه أصلا وفرعا خلافا ومذهبا وأن يكون كان الآلة بالاجتهاد عارفا بما يحتاج إليه في استنباط الأحكام من النحو واللغة معرفة الرجال تفسير الآيات الواردة في الأحكام والأخبار الواردة فيها وشر المستفتي أن يكون من أهل التقليد فيقلد المفتي في الفتية وليس العالم أن يلقب والتقليد قبول قول القائم لا حجة فعلى هذا قبول قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسمى تقليدا ومنهم من قال التقليد قبول قول القائل وانت لا تدري من اين قال فان قلنا ان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقول بالقياس فيجوز ان يسمى قبول قوله تقليدا واما الاجتهاد فهو بذل الوسع في بلوغ العرب فرض والمجتهد ان كان كامل الاله في الاجتهاد فان اجتهد في البلوغ فاصاب فله اجران ونجتهد فيها وأخطأ فله أجر واحد. ومنهم من قال كل مجتهد في الفروع مصيب، ولا يجوز أن يقال كل مجتهد في الأصول كلامه مصيب، لأن ذلك يؤدي إلى تصويب أهل الضلالة من النصارى والمجوس والكفار والموحدين. ودليل من قال ليس كل مجتهد في الفروع مصيب قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من اجتهد وأصاب فله أجران، ومن اجتهد وأخطأ فله أجر واحد. ووجه الدليل أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خطأ المجتهد تارة وصوبه أخرى.
The author rahimahullah concluded the last unit, which he speaks about four things. He speaks about Mufti, which is the Mufti. And the Mustafti is the one who's asking for the fatwa. And he speaks about the Mujtahid, Ijtihad. And he speaks about the Taqreed and the Muqallid. So he talks about four things. Mufti wal Mustafti, wal Mujtahid wal Muqallid. Four. And when he speaks about this chapter, he speaks 5 points. The whole chapter is talking about 5 points. Number one, the author speaks about shartul mufti, the condition of a mufti. What's a mufti? A mufti is al-mukhbiru an hukmin shar'iyyin. It's the one that's telling you about a ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the author, rahimahullah, he gives two conditions for the mufti. Two comprehensive definitions, two comprehensive conditions for the mufti. The first one is أن يكون عالما بالفقه. He is one who is a عالم of fiqh. أصلا وفرعا. He is a عالم of what? Of fiqh. أصلا وفرعا. In its sub-branches and it's in its foundations. So what does he mean by aslan? He means usul al-fiqh and the qawa'id al-fiqhiyya and furu' al-masail, which is fiqh, the furu' and the sub-branches. He knows the difference of opinion that have come regarding the fuqaha of his time, kal-hanafiyya, awil malikiyya, awil shafi'iyya, awil hanabila, and also the other fuqaha, their differences, he knows it. The second condition that he mentions for it is وَأَنْ يَكُونَ كَامِلَ الْآلَةِ فِي الْإِجْتِهَادِ, that he has complete ability in the instrumental knowledges. And he explains to you what it means, عِلْمُ الْآلَةِ. He says عَارِفًا بِمَا يُحْتَجُّ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْإِسْتِنْبَاطِ الْأَحْكَامِ مِنَ النَّحْوِ وَاللُّغَةِ. He knows the Arabic language. He knows grammar. When he says that he knows it, it doesn't mean al-ihatatu bil-ilm, that he fully encompasses grammar. There is no such a thing as anything to do with grammar except he knows it. That's not what it means. It means that he has a good ground, very strong, solid understanding of it. The author mentions, and he gives so much of that. The second thing that the author speaks about is shartul mustafti, the condition of who? The condition of who? The mustafti. Wa min shartil mustafti, from the conditions of the mustafti is the one who's asking for the fatwa. An yakuna min ahli taqlid, he has to be from the people of taqlid, blind followers. فَيُقَلِّدَ الْمُفْتِي فِي الْفُتْيَا, that he blind follows the muqallid, sorry, the mufti, that he's asking the question, that he blind follows him in the fatwa he gives him. So what's the mustafti again? The mustafti is الْمُخْبِرُ عَنِ الْحُكْمِ الشَّرْعِي أَيِ الْمُسْتَفْهِمُ عَنِ الْحُكْمِ الشَّرْعِي, is the one who wants to understand the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this matter. So the mustafti has to be what? أن يكون من أهل التقليد. Can the mustafti be from أهل الاجتهاد? No, he can't. He also mentions فَيُقَلِّدَ الْمُفْتِي فِي الْفُتْيَا, that he has to do taqlid on him. Then he says وَلَيْسَ لِلْعَالِمِ أَن يُقَلِّدَ, and it's not upon an alim to do taqlid. In what way? Like in حال القدرة, when he has the ability to do اجتهاد, he's not allowed to. Because the term عالم and the term فقيه is used for a mujtahid. Don't get fooled with that. If somebody says you're Fulan's a scholar or a alim, he means he's a mujtahid. It's the same. If he says he's a faqih, he means that he's a mujtahid. The author then mentions the third point, which is haqiqatu taqleed wa hadduhu. What's the reality of taqleed? And what does it mean? What's the definition? He says, wa taqleedu qabuli al-qawli al-qa'ili. Qabuli qawli al-qa'ili. It's that you accept the speech of the one who said it. So he mentioned two things. The first one is accepting the speech of the one who said it. And the second thing is, that you don't know where he got this from. وَأَنْتَ لَا تَدْرِي مِنْ أَيْنَ قَالَهُ. You don't know where he got this from. Is this his own ijtihad? Is this a delil he's based on? You don't know it. The author also said, فَإِنْ قُلْنَا if we say, إِنَّ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كَانَ يَقُولُ بِالْقِيَاسِ فَيَجُوزُ أَنْ يُسَمَّى قَبُولَ قَوْلِهِ تَقْلِيدًا. And this is a weak statement, which is, if we say that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would speak with analogy, then it's permissible to call the one who takes the Prophet's speech a muqallid. وَهَذَا قَوْلٌ فِيهِ نَظَرٌ. There's a look to this. The Prophet spoke with only what? وَحَيٌّ مِنَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. The fourth matter that the author, rahimahullah, mentions, which is حَقِيقَةُ الْإِجْتِهَادِ وَحَدُّ, the reality of ijtihad and what it means. And he mentions it's what? When two things are found. فَهُوَ بَذْلُ الْوُسْعِ. It is to put effort in. فِي بُلُوغِ الْغَرَضِ. And the second is to reach the غَرَض, which is the حُكُم شَرْعِ. So he's putting effort in getting to the bottom of a jurisprudent ruling. That's what ijtihad means. But that definition loses something, which is a third point which should be mentioned, which is the one who is mutaahil lin nazar al adilla, the one who has the rights to look at the adilla in the first place. The one who is, there's somebody who's allowed to do that. But there's another person, if he does it and he does ijtihad and he gets it right, he still gets a sin. Even if he gets it right, ya'am, he gets a sin. Who gave you the choice? Who told you to go to that? Who told you to go to the delil in the first place? Are you with me? The alim, on the other hand, who is a mujtahid, even if he gets it wrong, he gets a reward for it. Because he had the rights to speak about this issue by looking at the delil. The last point that the author, rahimahullah, mentions is hukm al-mujtahideen, the ruling of the mujtahid. Which is, إِذَا حَكَمَ الْحَاكِمُ فَاجْتَهَدَ ثُمَّ أَصَابَ فَلَهُ أَجْرَانَ وَإِنِ اجْتَهَدَ ثُمَّ أَخْطَأَ فَلَهُ أَجْرٌ. That the mujtahid is between two things. He's either between getting two rewards. Why two rewards? His effort and getting it right. That's two rewards. But if he gets it wrong, he's going to get rewarded for his effort, but not for getting it right, because he didn't get it right. That's the ruling of the mujtahid. And that's what the author, rahimahullah, concluded his book with. وَبِهَذَا نَكُودُ قَدْ فَرَقْنَا بِحَمْدِ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَرْحِ هَذَا الْمَتْنِ عَلَى مَا يُنَاسِبُ الْمَقَامِ. Anything which I have said that was wrong, incorrect, slip of the tongue, fault. فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْهُ. It's from me and Shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.